What's up guys, how you doing? Welcome to another video. So today we are talking all about the face detection autofocus, and in particular as well the eye autofocus with the Canon R6. I've tested it out for sports, going to talk a little bit about how it works, what I think of it, and I'm going to show you some images as well. Hope you guys are enjoying this kind of mini series that we're doing all about the Canon R6. If you are, do me a favor, hit that like button, make sure you subscribe for all of the future R6 videos that we're going to be doing right here on this channel. Without further ado, let's get into this. Let's start talking about this autofocus mode. So there's been a lot of talk about this, right? Out there on the forums and social media, loads of people saying, hey Rob, wait until you try the face detection autofocus, and telling me how good it was. I've seen other people do videos on it as well. Fronos Photo did a video about it where he used it on like to photograph like a quarterback training camp thing, and it looked really impressive. So I was excited to give it a try. I did just that the other day. I was down shooting a local football game and I used it in that method in the camera for like half the game, and I've got to say I was impressed with it. But we're going to talk about that in just a minute. First of all, I just thought I should touch on how it works. I've seen a few questions like asking like what is it, how does it work, and in very simple terms, right, in these cameras and in DSLRs you have like your traditional focus modes, right? And typically for sport, using like my 70-2 or my 1DX, I would always set my focus to the center point focus. Sometimes that slightly expanded one with a little cross, but center point focus, single point, that's where I sit for 99% of my sports work. As you guys will have seen in my other video, I set it up so that I used the single point for most of that sports test and all of the photos that you saw. What I also did later on in that game, which you didn't see in that video but you're going to see in this one, is that I switched it and set it to that face detection autofocus mode. Now, in very simple terms, and as always on this channel, these aren't like deeply scientific reviews. These are real world reviews to tell you how I have found it when I'm out there working and doing some jobs. The way that autofocus method works is it kind of tracks the image and tries to find a face. When it finds a face, it locks onto it and it tracks that face and stays with it, right? That's pretty much how that works in very, very simple terms. I've seen some other questions about like, what does it do when there's no face in the picture? What does it do if the face gets blocked or someone turns their head away? Well, in very simple terms, it still works fine. So what I did is I set up with Mrs. Sambles earlier on today and we filmed a couple of clips to demonstrate for you right here. So you can see, looking at the back of the camera, how that autofocus method works, right? It's tracking the face. You can see when the face turns to the side, it's still tracking, it's still looking for that face. You can see when it turns away, so you can't see the face at all. It's still tracking the back of that head because it's smart enough to know that that's the back of the head, that's where the face is, and as soon as you turn back again, it locks back onto the face. Works really well, right? You can even see in this next clip, when the face is obscured and blocked by something else, it just focuses on the nearest thing that it can, which is that bag. And then when that is moved out of the way, straight away it locks onto that face again. So hopefully that kind of answers those questions. You don't need to worry about like when you don't have a face at all, what's it going to do? It will lock on to the main kind of other thing, usually in the center of the image. So let's then talk about like how it actually worked for the football game. Now at this point here, I will start putting some images into the video, and all of these images were shot using the face detection autofocus. Now I've got to say, I found it to be really quick, really responsive. It locked on, it held focus really well. It tracked really well, didn't really have any problems with it at all. Sharp images, in focus, quick to snap that focus, and most importantly, combined with the way I do it, setting up the camera in servo mode, it tracked really well. So when I ran with a runner running towards me or to the side, it held on to that focus really, really well. I did notice one small issue, and that was when I was following someone's face that was perhaps a bit further away. So their face only kind of took up a small amount of the frame. And then if that person was moving and there were lots of other faces that started to appear or cross over in the frame, especially if any of those faces were closer to the camera than the original face I was tracking on, the camera panicked a little bit and didn't really know what to focus on. A good example is this photo right here, right? I took this photo, everyone's in focus, and I was tracking the guy in the center of the image. A second afterwards, the camera obviously panicked a bit about the amount of faces that were in the frame, didn't really know what to do, and it resulted in me getting this frame right here. It seemed to be over and done with and focused back on a person really, really quick, but you see what I mean. There was that slight moment of panic, and I think that was to do with how far away the subject was from me and the fact that some of the other faces probably appeared slightly bigger or more clear in that image. Another example is right here where I was tracking the guy running from right to left, and he crossed over with that guy in the background, and the camera very briefly locked onto that guy in the background. Lost the focus on the player that I was trying to get the shot of. But again, very, very quick, as soon as I kind of pointed back towards the player a little bit, it locked back onto him again and I was good to go. So overall, kind of what are we saying? Is it good? Is it bad? I would say overwhelmingly, I was really, really impressed with it. The speed of it, the accuracy of it was really, really good. Did I get a couple of small issues when I had more crowded frames with lots of people? Yeah, yes, I did, but I wasn't too upset about it. I probably didn't really miss any more than I would do with like regular focus where my center point comes off a player slightly, or I slightly misjudge and end up accidentally focusing on the background and stuff like that. Sometimes you get that, right? Sometimes that's human error. Sometimes the camera just locks onto something different. Every now and again that will happen. If you had an autofocus system that never ever did anything strange, well, you probably wouldn't need a professional photographer. You could just get anyone to point a camera at a game and press the shutter button. Overall, really impressed with the images that I got, and I certainly intend on using the face detection autofocus more and more. I'm going to be trying it out at some basketball this week. That's going to be combined with some really high ISO testing and testing that electronic shutter underneath some artificial lights, because I think that's going to make for a great video for you guys. I think that's about it, guys. Any questions related to the Canon R6, please do whack them in below. If you'd like to check me out on Instagram, we can see some more of my photos. Lots of the sports photos I talk about in these videos. Go check me out at Rob Samble Sport, and you can find me over there. Check out some photos. Make sure you hit the like button. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. Stick around for all the future R6 videos. And I'm going to see you guys on the next video.